日本の難民受け入れについてその
3 Part 3 about acceptance of refugees in Japan。
法務省は現在の難民申請者に対する受け入れ数の少なさに対して、難民申請者の大部分がやむを得ない事情の難民ではなく、不法滞在せずに日本で働こうとする偽装難民に該当するためだという見解を示しています。
When asked about the refugees, why the number is so extremely low, the Justice of Ministry of Justice has responded, has given a rationale that most of the applicants for refugee status are not actually genuine refugees and not in Japan for unavoidable circumstances, but rather that they are false refugees just seeking to work in Japan without illegally staying in Japan, in the country.
来日して難民申請をし、半年経つと全ての申請者が就労許可されるという制度が2010年に制定されました。
In 2010, the new regulation was established that once the person enters the country and applies for refugee status, then after 6 months they are awarded a working visa and they can work in Japan.
それ以来、就労目的と見られる申請者の数が急増したので、制度の悪用を抑制するために2018年に規定が変更されました。
And that regulation was revised in 2018 in order to curb the misuse of the system because the number of applicants for the refugees status in order to work in Japan has jumped rapidly.
新しい規定では、入国管理局が難民の可能性が高いと判断した申請者には、従来より速やかに就労が認められるようになりましたが、その一方、明らかに難民に該当しないと判断される申請者や、再申請を繰り返していると判断された申請者は、就労許可も新たな在留許可も得られないことになりました。
According to this new regulation, on one hand, the process for recognizing genuine refugees once they have applied to the immigration Ministry of Immigration has been sped up and has become more smooth, and the license for work has also been awarded. However, on the other hand, once it is clear that the applicant is not a genuine refugee and only seeks to work in Japan, then they are asked to reapply for a number of times, and once the judgment is made, they may not be able to reside in the country and may not be able to get a working permit.
実際に日本への難民申請者の大部分はフィリピン、ベトナム、スリランカ、インドネシアなど現在比較的安全だと認識されている国の出身者で占められています。
When we look at the actual numbers, the number of applicants, a large portion of applicants to, as refugees to Japan come from countries that are deemed as safe, such as Philippines,Vietnam, Sri Lanka, Indonesia, and so forth.
しかし、難民支援団体は、それらの国々出身者の中にも、本当に難民として庇護されるべき申請者はいるはずであり、不透明な審査基準によって、その人たちが十分な審査を受けられないまま認定を拒否されるべきではないと訴えています。
On the other hand, migrant support associations are saying that,Even among these countries deemed as safe, there might be people who are actually genuine refugees and must be protected by the Japanese government, and that very unclear judgment standards and unclear screening process or insufficient screening process is actually impeding on the rights of these people, and that should be stopped.